Escuchamos en nuestro Evangelio de hoy la proclamación de Dios por sus discípulos. He sent them out, dos a dos, two by two. And he sent them out two by two so that they were not by themselves, they were not alone. But he also, as he sent the prophet Amos in our first reading, sent them out as men of faith. En nuestro mundo ahora, fe es muy difícil por mucha gente, porque olvidamos la gracia de Dios, olvidamos la misericordia de Dios, olvidamos la ayuda de Dios cada día en nuestras vidas. Entonces es muy difícil por muchos de nosotros para vivir una vida con fe. But Christ shows us both in our gospel and in our first reading from the book of the prophet Amos, that we are called to rely on God. Muy similar de nuestro segunda lectura pasado el fin de semana, tenemos la esperanza que Dios puede ayudarnos y también que Dios es suficiente por nosotros, por cada cosa que necesitamos. ¿Creen en esto? ¿Creemos que Dios es suficiente? Sí, porque no vivimos este facto. It's easy to speak about having faith. It's easy to talk about having reliance on God. Es muy difícil para vivir esto. Muy difícil. Porque nuestros pensamientos no siempre están buenos. Porque Satanás no gusta buenos pensamientos en nuestras mentes. He wants to distract us from what is truly important. So what is important? ¿Qué es importante? Dios. Dios es la más importante cosa en nuestro mundo y también en nuestras vidas. God's love isn't just sufficient. God's love is more than we can ever deserve and more than we can ever understand. When the disciples were sent off two by two, they had nothing. Don't take any money. Don't take a second tunic. Just go. Into any town that they welcome you, stay there and preach the good news. And any town that they don't receive you, shake the dust from your feet against them. The disciples were men of faith. I don't know if I have the same faith that they had. Because luckily in the 21st century today, priests, when we were sent out, well, we aren't sent out two by two anymore because no tenemos demasiados sacerdotes. No tenemos sacerdotes suficientes en número ahora. And so when we're sent out, we have money in our pockets. Most of us have our own cars. Most of us have one, if not two or three extra pairs of shoes. I have one pair of shoes that I wear. They're my dress shoes, they're my running shoes, though I don't run, who am I kidding? They're technically my running shoes. And then I've got Crocs because, well, we want to get comfortable sometimes, right? Tenemos demasiado en nuestras vidas to distract us from what really matters. They didn't have technology in the same way that we do. They didn't have internet, they didn't have phones. They couldn't pass information quickly. In fact, it was fascinating that by the time Mass got out, earlier at the 5 o'clock Mass, I had multiple parishioners coming to me telling me the news that had happened this evening. For those who hadn't heard, there was a shooting at the rally with President Trump this evening, and he got shot in the ear. But the update is, one of the people that was in the crowd got killed. Another person's in critical condition. in the chaos of our world, do we truly rely on God? David tells us in the Psalms, put not your faith in princes, put not your faith in men, and yet that's what we do. So much so that it distracts us, it divides us from what really matters in life. Oh, if this person becomes president, the world's going to hell. We've been saying that for 250 years. And yet, we're still here. Now, we're closer to hell than we've ever been because the world around us is embracing evil. But hope still exists. God still exists. Pero nuestro mundo no creen en Dios. Y algunos de nosotros tienen problemas cada vez, no cada vez, pero algunas veces, con nuestra fe también. Cuando olvidamos el amor de Dios, ingresamos nuestros pecados. Tenemos la oportunidad para reconciliar. Para reconciliación, tres veces cada semana, en inglés o español, no me importa. Pero muchos de nosotros, oh, no tengo pecados malos. I haven't killed anybody. I haven't committed adultery. Bueno. Pero somos pecadores y tenemos pecados que necesitan la perdón de Dios. Cada de nosotros, yo también. Es la razón por qué, por mí, por mínimo dos veces cada mes, recibo la gracia de Dios en el sacramento de reconciliación. Porque necesito la ayuda de Dios para vivir, para predicar, para celebrar la misa. Y también porque soy un pecador. Pero mi identificación no es como mis pecados. Primero, soy un hijo de Dios. Esto es nuestra identificación. Dice esto cada semana porque es muy importante para entender esto y para vivir esto. Porque nuestro mundo no cree en esto. Es obvio con la nueva esta noche que gente afuera de la iglesia no creen en Dios. Pero también probablemente es cierto que en nuestras familias que hay gente que no creen en Dios. ¿Con ellos? ¿Oran por ellos? ¿Invitan ellos para entender misa? Oh, padre, mi familia no gusta misa. Muchos de nuestros niños gustan misa. Pero los padres, oh, tengo excusas, padre, lo siento. Don't apologize to me. Apologize to God. You're not letting me down, you're letting God down. Pero es la responsabilidad de los padres para hacer un modelo por sus niños. Ah, oh, padre, no me gusta misa porque hoy I'm mad at God. Life isn't going how I want it to. Things are going wrong. I don't have a job. My spouse cheated on me. I'm cheating on my spouse. I just got fired. I can't find a job. I'm worried about my immigration status. I'm worried about the immigration status of those around me. I'm worried about the police. I'm worried about school. I'm worried about whatever it may be. Dios es más de suficiente por nosotros. Si creemos con fe. But we must rely on God. every moment of every day. And when we don't, receive God's grace and mercy in the sacrament of reconciliation. That's it. Es muy fácil, pero es muy difícil para vivir. La respuesta es muy fácil. The Lord even tells us, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. The burden of life is not easy and is not light. But what the Lord does for us is amazing. If we invite him in and allow him to take care of us. But it takes intention. It takes practice. It takes change to make a difference. So in faith this day, may we see how the Lord has blessed us. And during this Mass, may we truly give thanks to God for those blessings.